So this, in Chapter 5, the testing overview, this is Brian Kernahan, the author, one of the Bell Labs heroes, who's the author of the Kernahan and Ritchie book on C that probably most of you had. If you read it a couple times, you can get it. Debugging is twice as hard as writing code in the first place. Therefore, it's twice as hard, right? So therefore, if you write the cleverest code the first time, you're never going to be able to debug it because it's twice as hard. All right, this one, this is Dijkstra. And you got to fill in the blank. Testing can never demonstrate the absence of errors, only their presence, right? Well, that's been around for a long time, and just got to keep that in mind. Here is an article that came out a year and a half ago, and it says, why are things expensive? And you can see here that their study is it's not that there's bugs inherently in the design, it's just lousy testing features. Lousy testing processes are reasons that there's so many bugs in code. And it says here that completely automated testing environments are rare. This was a year and a half ago, still rare. Just 12% of software development organizations have fully automated testing system. 10% do all testing manually, right? So you write the test, you look at the output, you write the test, you look at the output. And see any mistakes? Okay. So, wow, can't believe that that's still true. That's not true here. for Agile, before the hand, you'd have a separate quality assurance team, so you'd have all these phases and separate groups of people. So somehow, the quality assurance team was supposed to insert quality in your code or make sure that you have quality in your code. With Agile, it's part of everything we do. We're testing continuously. Every week we bring out new code. You're responsible for testing your code, not somebody else. And the tools are highly automated, so unlike that statement that was done before. And so what the argument here in the led to the Agile manifesto is that if with a good process we'll get software quality, rather than there's a specific group that's supposed to ensure it, that they're going to beat you up if you don't have it. So BDD and TDD, as I said earlier, the phrase behavior-driven design was inspired by some people getting confused about test-driven development. Here we're testing acceptance tests, integration tests, and trying to capture the behavior. TDD is going to do step definitions and actually write unit tests and functional tests before you write the code. So that's the now. So the good news is you're always going to have the tests up to date because you're writing it as you're writing the code or even before it. So here's how they work together. Cucumber described the features. You start off writing the stories you want. They fail. Then it invokes the implementations, the RSpec test. If it fails, you implement the methods that are missing. And then when it passes the RSpec test, you keep iterating internally until you pass the RSpec. And then once you've implemented the feature properly, it'll pass the Cucumber green step, and you go back and keep going through the development.